Hello! This particular contraption, followed by fear, shielded by pride, and pride of British Empire. Named Britannia, she sits on the waves between England and France, and the waves, she's supported by a small pair of water wings. The water wings are sinking slowly, so she rushes for enlightenment. And grabbing a trolley in the supermarket, she picks up a few Buddha biscuits, a small helping of Krishna cookies, and a large help yourself packet of Jesus jumpers. And all of these she stuffs in her little tight mouth and chews upon till fully masticated and spits them out into a big aeroplane-shaped balloon, which grows bigger and bigger and doesn't feel bruises. Until it's so big, she can pull out a little knife, slit a hole in the bottom, and empty the contents onto a small sheet of manuscript paper, which when rotated at a speed of 33 and a third RPM, nearly finished, sounds like this. Can you tell me where?
Thank you. was a young man called Romeo.
Romeo, very easy name to remember that. And Romeo had his small bundle, which was hopping by his knees below his waist. And with tremendous courage, this young man, Romeo, don't forget the name, he removed it. He grabbed it with his fingers and pulled it right off. And snatched everything up. Nice hot oven, left it there for 2 weeks. Simple hot oven, leave it there for 2 weeks. But the pandas have changed colour completely, beyond recognition. Really right out. And he stuffed his fungus and crumbled it in his little fingers and bunged it in his mouth, chewed upon it, and then swallowed it, producing in Romeo a high degree of sexual excitation. I carry with me, some of you may be familiar with this, a small piece of subtle symbolism. This explains perhaps the predicament our hero now found himself in. And as some of you in our audience tonight might be well aware, such pieces of subtle symbolism can become extremely tiring and carried around for long periods. And it was very fortunate that our hero Romeo, don't forget the name, it's just around the corner was the answer to his problems, a young lady called Juliet, singing sweetly to herself on a balcony, lived like this.
Come up and get me!
This beautiful melodious voice produced in our hero something with which we are now well familiar. He was much excited by the motion on the balcony. So encouraged was he that he grabbed the young lady off and led her into the darkness and obscurity of the building in the city called the cinema. And the local newspaper reported the whole as the cinema show.
walked into the park, which was never closed, and there everything looked exceptionally clean and green. I'd like Tim Stewart, give a hand for Tim Stewart, our star roadie of the evening. So old Michael took off all his clothes and rubbed his very pink, marbly flesh into the clean green grass. This produced a high degree of sexual excitation. Yeah, we had that one. Well, you know what you get from Genesis. Same old shit. And this little venture was accompanied by the sincere and severe tapping on the ground with his fingers. Beneath the ground, a little bit of batter was interpreted as rainfall. Rainfall to worms means two things. Mating and bath time. Both of these were enjoyed. Within seconds, the clean green surface of the park was a mass of dirty brown swamp worms. Old Michael continued to rub his very pink flesh into the dirty brown mess. He smiled a little smile and whistled a tune. This is the bit that won us tremendous ovations in America every night. It's not worth it. Genesis' one and only contribution to rock and roll. It means to the little birds in the sky, not Jerusalem boogie, but supper is ready.
Thank you.
left, we climb up the mountain of human flesh to a plateau of green grass and green trees full of life. The young figure sits still by the pool. He's been scant human bacon by some butchery tool. He hears you. Social security took care of this lad. We watch in reverence as Narcissus is turned to a flower.
Thank you. Thank you.